Hello, everybody. My name is Rick Horn. I'm the pastor of the Full Gospel Tabernacle. Got my little nephew, Joe David Marbley, with me tonight. I want to say how much we appreciate this station and Sister Margaret and all of you folks out there that support this station. If it wasn't for this station, there are so many people that wouldn't get to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ, the nursing homes, the hospitals, people that are shut in at their homes. Not only just them, there's a lot of people that don't ever go to church, and this station reaches them. So many souls. We sang here tonight, and there was over around five souls that got saved, or six. And we just thank the Lord for this station and Sister Margaret. God bless you.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We have a lot of guests and we're going to just be moving right along, but we welcome each of you to the service tonight. And regardless of where you are or what your situations are, we want to share the good news with you, and that is that the Lord loves you and He knows how to fix things for you.
Amen.
And one scripture we want to read, and that is in the first book of Psalms, and it's the first verse. It said, "Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night." That's Psalms, the first psalm in the Bible. And so if we think day and night about the work of the Lord, we're going to get something accomplished.
Amen.
If we get up and work.
Yes, Lord.
And so we have some more good news to share with you tonight. And this is, we have published the Heir of Harvest programs, both live and on demand videos on Roku and Google TV. Since May the 21st, only 7 days, we have gained 28,060 viewers from these channels. Now, so we want to welcome all of you throughout the United States, Canada, the United Kingdom, Mexico, and a total of 15 countries. And so if this is a new way that people can pick up WLJC. It's different from any way that we've been on before, and it is a brand new avenue for us. And so we just thank the Lord for it. So now if you want any more information on how to connect with this, call Rachel here at the office at 859-229-6679. And she'll explain more to you. And we're just so thrilled and so excited about this new avenue of spreading the gospel. And so, you know, only God can do things like this. And so we're thankful for that. We have, like I say, a lot of good help tonight. We have Brother Cecil. He always comes on this night to help on the phones, but he has some things to share. Then we have Preacher Bill Holman and his buddies with him. And so we're going to go over here and let them share a few minutes with you. And then we have a good group of singers coming up. And so you're going to be blessed, because if your heart is turned toward God tonight, then He can bless you.
Amen. You know, Sister Margaret, I thank the Lord you've held the station here. And you know, it's so important to a lot of people out there in the country that don't go to church or can't get to church. But we've had a couple services lately. And just to share with you what WLJC is doing throughout the country, and especially in the local areas. You know, she's mentioned in all those countries that's being added on. But did you know, I believe the Spirit is pouring out today. He said He'll pour His Spirit out on all flesh. And you know, we had a service of Margaret Faye Chasteen. And this, now I want you to hear this. These people are hungry for the Word of God. And now listen, this Word is going out through that airways and through that TV. And so important that we listen. Right here is Teresa come to the Lord from Miss Chasteen's family. Okay, now listen, here's Phyllis prayed right there to be saved at the same place. Carol at Richmond, she prayed. And you know what? These people are praying because, you know, like Mary and Martha was, they wanted to see Jesus. They wanted to talk to Jesus because their brother had died. Amen. And did you know, these people wanted to get to the Lord. They wanted comforting. You know, today's day, we need comforting. We need that power of God. This thing is real. And I love it today. And here's Jeanette from Richmond also gave her life to the Lord. You know, they prayed this prayer now. You believe they got saved, preacher? That's between them and the Lord. Our job, Bill, is to direct them that away. Amen. And right here's another one. You know, Virginia has come to the Lord and asked God to give her a home in heaven because, folks, these people's hearts is open and they can see that their loved one has went on to another life. I believe in heaven. Glory to God. And I believe Jesus is standing there. Here's Bobby from Richmond. And right here is Carl from Richmond. And Patsy, they're putting up that cross. You love, everybody out there in TV lands loves to watch that cross go up. Yes, I know yes, they do. Yes. Here's Patsy also has prayed to come to the Lord just because of that our way. And Sister Margaret and the staff and everyone praying. And we're standing together on this. And right here, Lois from Richmond. These people is all. I believe there's a downpour in there, don't you guys? And Jessica from Richmond. And Clayton from Richmond. And you know, not only that, all these people has got come to the Lord, but listen, this station is open to everybody. God has got, I believe the word, Sister Margaret, United States is unraveling, but God is right there with open arms, Bill. And you know, not only that, we had a service for May Ritchie, and also five of her people gave their lives to the Lord right in Owsley County here today. And I thank God for that. You can put them crosses up because it's so real. You know, the Bible said in Acts 2, He made us a promise, Sister Margaret. And that promise is still holding up, guys. Listen to me. That you and your house can be saved. But one thing, I've heard Miss Sister Margaret say it many times. We are the light to her family. Yeah. And we need to let it shine bright. I praise God that these people's praying. You know, Sister Margaret, we can sing, we can preach, we can do whatever, but have we forgot how to pray? Mm-hmm. You know, we need to look to the Lord as the author and the finisher of our faith, Bill, and give Him the praise. We'll be up answering phones tonight. God bless you. And if you need the Lord tonight, if you need comforting, just call WLJC and we'll be in that upper room.
Amen.
All right. Thank you, Pastor Cecil Burns. Now we have Preacher Bill Holman, and he has something special to share with
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Hi, everybody. I am so glad to be here tonight, hearing about these people that have trusted the Lord.
Amen.
We have a Bible camp in the summertime, and we'd like for you to go Singers. With us. And so some boys and girls may be out playing. They might not be watching television. Adults, mamas and daddies, grandmas, call the kids in. I'll be just in a few minutes with Henry and Homer. So tell the kids come in if they want to see
yes.
Henry and Homer, and we'll talk with them also. Okay, don't forget, get the kids in there.
Amen.
Okay.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes. All right, and that'll be just a little bit later. And meanwhile, we have some singers coming up that you'll enjoy. But first, let's stop and pray.
Yes, Lord.
We never want to try to go into this service without God's blessing on it, because you know that human help is not much, but with the anointing, that's when things happen.
Amen.
So, Father, in the name
yes,
of Jesus,
my God.
We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for the Salvation Reports. Yes, we thank you for the advancement of the ministry, and Lord, only you could do this. And we know that different means of spreading the gospel is accepted by so many different people. So tonight, Lord, we ask you to bless each person that will be having a part in this service. Bless and anoint the singers, the phone operators, and Lord, we all want to do the what we can,
yes, Lord,
to get people's attention in serving you. So give us a good night and victory in the service. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, tonight for our singers, we have Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio, and they're from West Liberty, and they have CDs for sale. I'm not sure how many years it is that Ernest has been in the music business, but a little while, and stayed true to the Lord and sung many songs for him. And you know, what you do for him is recorded, and so that is good. So his phone number is 606-743-2847, or it's the number to get in touch with him. But right now, let's welcome Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio.
Amen.
Hey,
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 hey. Approaching soon, Jesus will come to cry all over the world, even in the center world, other countries, that Jesus is coming soon. Amen. Folks, and soon the cry is going to be, he has come. So it pays us, if you don't know him, tonight will be the night, because we want to live forever, and only if we can live with Jesus. When we're born, we enter to a world of fear with sin. When we die, we live again. We can only believe. And I can live forever when I get to heaven. I can talk to Jesus. I can see the Lord. Living in his mansion, walking in his kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord.
on the cross of Calvary. Jesus died for you and me. If we only believe in him, you can live again, my friend.
And I can live forever when I get to heaven. I can talk to Jesus, I can see the Lord.
Can't you just imagine living in his mansion, walking in his kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord? When our life on earth is through, we'll be judged for what we do. And the trumpet of the Lord to sound, that old grave can hold me down. And I can live forever when I get to heaven. I can talk to Jesus, I can see the Lord. Just imagine living in a mansion, walking in the kingdom of the Lord. On earth, we'll be judged by what we do, and the trumpet of the Lord shall sound. That old grave can hold me down, and I can live forever when I get to heaven. I can talk to Jesus, I can see the Lord. Can't you just imagine? Living in his mansion, walking in his kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord. Walking in his kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord.
Yes, indeed, walking in his kingdom. What a thrill.
Amen.
What wonderment that will be over on the other side. Sister Margaret, it's so delightful to be back on this fine program tonight. And I might remind our viewers, of those who haven't been tuned in all these years, we started with you and your religious broadcasts way back in the 60s. And still holds true today. Sister Margaret is still going full steam. And me, and it was the hymn trio back then, but it's the Bluegrass Hymn Trio tonight, and we've got some guests with us we'll be bringing out, and we've got the Wheelhouse with us back again. Sister Margaret, thank you for loaning Don with us tonight again on the old bass. Hi, Don.
This is a new
bass. What?
New one.
He's pulling one on me. I can't hardly hear too good. I don't know what it is. It must be the weather outside. I don't let on anything else. But anyway, we'll do this for Brother Bill and Sister Sharon over there, Shannon. And there's a storm a brewing, and Sister Margaret was telling us about the good news on the many countries that we're reaching out to here on WLJC, and that thrills my Christian heart tonight. You going to kick it?
The ship was tossed because the sea was rough. The waves were roaring high. Peter and John were searching for a way they would all live and not die. Then they remembered the one who had led them lying in the ship fast asleep. They said, "Let's tell Jesus the winds are blowing. Time for the master to speak. It's time to wake the master. a ship's going down. The waves are churning and turning my life upside down. It's time to wake the master. He's got the words that I need. When the spirit moves in, he wakes the master in me. Let's play a lot of music, Carter. But he does not sleep. The good book says he's always attentive to the prayers of us, and we're thankful tonight. Tell about your guest, Carter. You've got a fine guest, and on the second portion, we're going to have him and my cousin, Dale Hall from Ohio, come up and sing for the folks. They've got it busted up about equal, so tell about your guest here.
Yeah, definitely. Glad to have him here with us tonight. Fine young gentleman that I work with, and we play a lot of music and sing a little bit together from over in Salyersville, Kentucky. Yeah. We want to hear him sing some tonight, too. I'm going to give him my time on the singing portion.
Well, maybe the clock has always been good to us when we're over here. Lady Mary singing your beautiful song all about the old rich man and Lazarus and what will happen if we are blessed with wealth in this life and don't give unto the master. It's called If I'd Known Jesus in April.
We read of a man with riches and gold who needed nothing, not silver or gold, while another man lay at the gate full of sores, wanting only the crumbs that fell to the floor.
What if I had known Jesus, the rich man now says, I'd fed the beggar, while a beggar found peace, he never found bread.
So many today are straying in sin, refusing our Savior to come in. Not thinking of Jesus, never stopping to pray. How sad at the judgment to hear them all say. But if I had known Jesus, my soul would be free. I know I would listen when he calls to me. If I could recall just one single thing, I'd bow on my knees and call on his name. But now it's too late for me to find rest. If I had known Jesus, I'd give him my best. If I had known Jesus, I'd give him my best.
Guarantee. Mary, what's on your heart tonight? You've got some folks you dedicate to, and maybe tell folks where we're going to be picking and singing.
First of all, I want to thank all the customers that came by and brought Memorial Day flowers from me, and they knew I was going to be on television here, and they will be watching tonight, and I so appreciate it, meeting so many different people and getting to talk with them and comfort them in their time of sorrow when they were buying flowers. I really appreciate that. And I just have so many beauty shop customers that are listening tonight, and I just can't name them all, but I love yous, and I appreciate yous. Yous have all took care of me all these 33 years, and I just appreciate that so much. So I send this out all to you guys tonight, and I love yous, appreciate it. And I'll send out to the West Liberty, where I do chaplain work, the West Liberty Prison and the Sandy Hook Chapel, and they'll be listening tonight, and that's one important part of my life, is getting to go do ministry at the West Liberty Prison. And the men just so enjoy having church and singing and praising God. So that goes out to all of you tonight. Thank you.
If we've got anything to smile about tonight, it's what Sister Margaret read there at the beginning of the service to us in private about many countries that have been added to her program. And that's thrilling tonight, Sister Margaret. We just rejoice with you. Okay, well, this says, keep on the sunny side.
For you, light of white.
You're the bright and sunny side of life. There's a dark and sunny side, too. Though we meet with the darkness of life, the sunny side we also may view. Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day. It will brighten all our way. It will keep on the sunny side of life.
Away, the sun again will shine bright and clear.
Keep on sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day.
It will brighten all our way. It will keep on the sunny side of hope each day. Though the moon might be cloudy or fair, let us trust in our Savior each day to keep us everyone in His care.
Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day. It will brighten all our way. It will keep on the sunny side of life. It will keep on the sunny side of life.
All right, good advice there, folks. Keep on the sunny side. I was supposed to send our theme song, and I'm glad my son, number one, David, I'm not glad he didn't make it tonight, but he got caught up in court. He had to appear for another person on a trial, and he couldn't make it, but he don't hardly like us to sing that theme song. He's heard it since he was a little boy, I guess. We theme song it everywhere, but it tells a good message. And there's a man that called me up around London, Charles Flincham. And Charles wanted us to do that song, especially for him and his wife tonight. So, Charles, we did the song, but now we're sending it out to you. Okay, she said one more song, and let's. Well, he's going to get his guest. You got to hurry because they want him. Okay.
Come on up here, buddy.
Tell who he is, Carter. Sing us happy.
Sing us happy.
Lord, like the flowers need the sunshine and the rain. I need you just like the seasons need the winter and the spring. I'm not very much more. I need you to see. Make it without me, Lord, but I can't make it without you. Like a child without its mother's hand to hold to, Lord, that's just exactly how I am. In your footsteps, no matter what others do, 'cause you can make it without me, Lord, but I can't make it without you. Need the sunshine and the rain. I need you just like the season need the wind and the spring. God very much, Lord. I need you to see me through, 'cause you can make it without me, Lord, but I can't make it without you. And you can make it without me, Lord, but I can't make it without you.
How true that song is. We can't make it without the Lord, but he could do without us. But so we need to appreciate the good things he's done for us. Well, the group is going to take a little break and get some water, and right now we have Preacher Bill and his buddies, and they've got a good message for everybody from the young to the old. So take it away.
Hi, Preacher Bill. Well, hi, Henry. You mean that's the way you talk to your friends? Sure do. I see some people out there, too. There's some people behind the camera out there in their television at home, too. Can I speak to them? Uh-huh. Go ahead. Will they speak back to me? Sure they will. You're their they're your friends, aren't they? Oh, yeah. Hi, everybody. I didn't hear them. Well, see, they're still at their house, most of them. Homer, can you say hi to everybody? Yeah, but I'll have to talk it big and loud. No, they can hear you. The microphone in their home, they can turn it up if they need to, but I don't think they need to. Go ahead and say hi to them. Okay. Hi, everybody! No. You don't have to yell. Say it nice and sweet. Do what now? When you say hi to people, if you want them to be your friend, you're supposed to say it nice and sweet. Okay, I'll do that. Do it nice now, Homer. Yeah, he will. Go ahead. All right. Hi, honey. Honey, I didn't mean to say it nice and sweet that way. I just wanted to say it real nice. I got a question for the girls out there in television land. You got a question for the girls in television land? Yeah. What do you want to ask? I want to ask them, not you. Yeah, he's going to ask the girl. Go ahead, ask them. All right. Girls, I got a question for you. Go ahead. Will you marry me? No, that's silly. They, boys and girls don't have any interest in that kind of stuff, right? I never heard the like in my life. Me neither. I can't believe Homer would say a thing like that. Yeah, he doesn't really like friends. Well, he'd like for you to be his friend. Oh, he would? I sure would. He wants to. Okay. Homer? Yeah. Buddy, you look like an angel. That was nice. You think he looks like an angel? I sure do. All right. That's the way you make friends. You're showing the boys and girls how they're supposed to act and do the right thing and make friends, right? Yeah. And he does look like an angel. He does? Well, Henry looks like a saint. That was nice. You guys are buddies with one another, aren't you? And you think he looks like an angel? And you think he looks like a saint? Yeah. Why do you think he looks like an angel? He's always up in the air hearting about something. No. That isn't the way you say. You know better than that. Will you quit laughing at your silly jokes? Homer, don't say anything mean back to him. You think he looks like a saint? Yeah, looks like a Saint Bernard to me. Saint Bernard, apologize to him. Apologize? What's that? You don't know how to say to people you're sorry? Oh, that's what you want me to say? Say it to Homer. That's the way you make friends, when you tell him you're sorry. Okay, Homer, yeah. I'm sorry you look like an angel. That isn't the way I wanted you to say it, but you still just apologize for calling him a saint. Yeah, I will. Okay, do it, buddy. All right, I'm sorry you look like a dog. A what? I'll get him. No, now, boys, we don't fight. Oh, yes, we do. No, what I mean is we're not supposed to fight. Boys and girls learn how to get along good with one another. And in the summertime, they get to go to camp, too. And we're going to talk about that just in a minute, okay? Yeah, I still like Homer. You do? Yeah. Hey, Homer. Yeah, buddy. Would you do me a great big favor? You really want him to do you a big favor? Yeah, that's the way friends talk. And you want, what do you want him to do for you? I want him to go jump in the river. He still wants to fight. No, see, we're not supposed to fight. We're supposed to be nice to one another. And we learn that kind of thing as we go to a camp in the summer. There's a whole lot of them that I like one better than all the others. Oh, you do? What camp do you like? Youth Haven Bible Camp. That's right here in Lee County where this television station is. Yeah. Boys and girls, I think you've heard about that camp. They have. What kind of camp is it? You don't know? Guess he doesn't. Explain it to him. Hey, Homer. Yeah. Buddy, we have a lot of good things for kids at our camp, Youth Haven. What do you have? Yeah. He'd like to know, I think. The kids would like to know. Go ahead and tell them. What do you have at that camp? We have horses to ride. You got horses to ride? Oh, boy. I like to ride horse. And you got horses there at that camp? Yep. Nah, I still don't want to go. Well, talk him into it. Well, don't you like to ride paddle boats? Yeah. You like to ride paddle boats? You got paddle boats at that camp, too? Sure do, buddy. Oh, I like to ride paddle. And you sure you got them that you can't? Yes, buddy. Yeah, I still don't want to go. Come on now, Homer. Yeah, everybody ought to want to go to camp in the summertime. That gives us a chance to be out with our friends and get to go to camp. Tell him what you get to do at camp. We get to sit at the dining table with our friends. You mean I get to sit beside you? I imagine, yeah, right? Yeah, but we also get to sleep in the same dorm. You mean to tell me we're going to tell those boys and girls that if they go to this camp, they can have their friends, it's a double bunk, and they can sleep in the top or the bottom bunk, and their friend there with them? That's right. I still don't want to go. He doesn't still want to go. Oh, it's all right. I don't care if he doesn't go. Well, I do care. I want him to go, and I want all the boys and girls to go, too, because it's a lot of fun. Yeah, but I don't care if he doesn't go. I'm just going to tell my cousin he's not going to be there. Your cousin's going to be there? His cousin's going to be there. Your cousin? Yep. Oh, yeah. I like to ride horses. I like to ride paddle boats. Yeah, buddy. And my cousin's going to be there. Whoopee, I want to go to camp. Yeah. No, I don't think I'll go. Yeah, come on. Come on, go to camp. I want to ask you. You say your cousin's going to be there? Yeah. Yeah, his cousin's going to be there. Well, what does your cousin look like? Why, buddy, she's real good looking. Oh, boy. Yeah, I want to go to camp. You say you got horses and paddle boats? Yeah, even got a swimming pool. That's right. We got a lot of things. What? I still don't want to. What does she look like, Henry? You mean my cousin? Yeah. She is real good looking. She looks just like me. She does? Yeah. I decided I don't want to go then. Homer? You mean you're just playing? Yeah. I want to go to camp. And you're going to be there? Yep. And we get to ride the train, too? Yeah, we have a miniature train. We got a lot of things there. They'd have fun all day long, wouldn't they? That's right. I'm going to be there. And you know what? What? I'm going to be there, too. Thank you. Boys and girls, you going to be there? I hope they... Do you know what they have to do? They have to get a paper by calling the camp, and I think the phone number is listed for them, but they can call and say, I want a paper so I can sign up to go to camp. And it's Youth Haven Bible Camp, right here in Ladysdale, Lee County, Kentucky. Right. I hope they get to come. Me too. Let's all go to camp, kids. You'll have the time of your life. I agree. Thank you for coming. Can you say goodbye? Well, yeah. Can we say it different? Say it your way. All right. Adios, amigos. Adios. Oh, you mean adios is goodbye in Spanish. And amigos is friends? Yeah. He said goodbye to his friends. I can do that, too. All right, do it. All right. Cyanide. Cyanide. Oh, he means sayonara. See, sayonara is goodbye in the Japanese language. Everybody's saying it in different language. You meant sayonara. No, I did not. I meant cyanide. Cyanide is poison. Yeah, that's goodbye in anybody's language. Will you guys get down in your box? Be quiet. You said goodbye to everybody and lay still. I still want them to go to camp. I know, and so do I. Maybe they've already decided they're going to get one of these papers that tell all about Youth Haven Bible Camp, and it's only $70 for a whole week. Wow. I hope they go. I do, too. Be quiet now. Be getting still. Okay. Henry, I said be quiet. I heard you. Don't say that again. Okay. Don't say okay again. All right. You're in trouble. No, I'm not. Yeah, you are. Lay still. I want a drink of water. You do that every time, and the kids know that you are not thirsty. Yes, I am. You speak out one more time, I'm going to come in there and whip you. When you come, bring your drink of water. Oh, boys and girls, don't be like Henry and Homer. Let's make sure we plan to go to camp. Thank you for listening. Bye, kids.
All right, Preacher Bill and Homer and Henry. And we do have the number there that you can contact, and they'll be glad to hear from you. A lot of good things happen at Youth Haven Camp. All right, we're back to singing Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio, and they have a lot more good songs for us, and so let's just welcome them back.
Thank you, Lady Margaret, and Henry and Homer. I've never followed an act like that. That's cute, brother. All for the glory of God. The Pico brothers over in Moorhead, Round County, are good friends of mine for years. They're cattle buyers, Tom and Nick, and their sisters, Elizabeth and Eileen. And they always prime Tom about a week ahead that we're going to be on WLJC. So they're listening tonight. And Sister Margaret, tell the folks upstairs that they're probably listening. Brother Cecil and all of them that... Tom still hasn't, he's been waiting on a kidney transplant. And the way I see it, if anyone needs one, deserves one, it's Brother Tom. He's a kind gentleman. You can't say that about all horse traders, but I know him personally. He's bought my cows and calves for many years, and hopefully God will give him many more years and keep doing that. And let's remember him upstairs, Tom Pico and his family. Here's a song entitled, "I'm and Carter's on the Fiddle, I Met a Man." Now I'm not calling on the phone to say come along, for I'm not going out tonight to drink and honky-tonk. I've served Satan all my life, bound in sin and shame. I met a man the other night, and Jesus is his name.
I met a man the other night, Jesus is his name.
I met a man the other night, my whole life has been changed.
That's why I called you on the phone to tell you this one thing.
I met a man the other night, and Jesus is his name.
Fiddle. This man, King Jesus is his name. Yes, Mary, you have some more dates where we're going to be. And while she's doing that, my cousin Delmer drove all the way down from Ohio to be with us tonight, Sister Margaret. And this is about, what, the third or fourth time as he's been with us down through the years, guessing here on this fine program. So we've got him again tonight, and we're happy to have him. Mary, then we'll get our cousin.
Grab a pen and pencil. I know when they're giving dates, I don't have a pen ready, and I don't write it down. We're going to be singing at Irving, Kentucky, Sunday morning, June the 1st at 10 o'clock a.m. at the Easter Valley Baptist Church, where Pastor Mike Davis, song director Steve Isaac. We'll be singing in Trotwood, Ohio, Saturday, June the 7th at 6 o'clock at Victoria's Country Inn, 6925 West 3rd Street, with Lester Miller, who has booked us. We'll be singing in Dayton, Ohio, Sunday morning, June the 8th, 9:30 at the Wayside Chapel, 4900 Colonel Glenn Highway, Pastor Dale Brown. Mike's been acting up all evening. When all done, I'm sorry. Okay, now June the 11th, we're going to be doing a revival on Wednesday at 7 o'clock p.m. June the 11th, we're doing a revival with Mount Zion Fellowship Christian Church, State Route 3310. That's in Oak Ridge, Kentucky, where Pastor Jerry Lavender and Brother Lewis Marshall and his wife has booked us. And then on Saturday, July the 12th, we're going to be at the Full Gospel Deliverance Church, Quicksand Road, Jackson, Kentucky, with Pastor Gordon Little. I'll give the rest of them after a while.
Mary, at the church there at Quicksand, we've known that pastor for many, many years. And there's a young man, he's either assistant pastor there, song director, and Bill Collins. Bill, we want you to tune your guitar strings real tight when we come to be with you folks. We love you. Right now, here is my cousin from up in Dayton. I want to say Dayton, but he lives in a little, Dayton's a suburb of your town. What's the name of it, Dale?
West Alexandria, Ohio. It's close to Dayton there.
All right. Dale sang for the Lord and Sister Margaret and the folks here. Dale Hall.
I'm walking along by an old country church. A voice I heard seemed to say, I lifted my eyes and Jesus appeared. His raiment was bright as the day. Oh, Lord, I cried as I knelt to pray. Tears filled my eyes, and He washed my burdens away. Told him that I'd been a sinner too long. Asked him to show me the way. Told him it was sad he had died on that cross, that I could be saved here today. Oh, Lord, I cried as I knelt to pray. Tears fill my eyes, and He washed my burdens away. Yes, He washed my burdens away. All away. Yep.
Oh. We met some folks over at there at the restaurant a while ago at Arby's, wasn't it? And a young lady, and she said her dad watches this show every night. And forgive me, I forgot his name, but anyway, we'll send that out to them and the folks over there at Arby's if it's all right. Go ahead.
Say another.
Hook it,
man. Okay. Hook it.
We got Kiwi.
I got the love of God within, Lord, makes me happy. And I know the Lord has really saved my soul. I remember when I came down to God's altar, where He took away my sins, made me whole. Well, this old sinful world is full of trouble. I gave up this world to find a better home. And I know the hand of God, He'll always guide me. For He'll teach me the right way from the wrong. I got that love of God within, makes me happy. And I know the Lord has really saved my soul. I remember when I came down to God's altar, where He took away my sin, made me whole. Friends have turned me down, the Lord will help me. He'll be there when my troubles are hard to stand. I'm so glad to know for sure I've met the Master. And
I'll meet you at them gates in glory land. I got that love of God within, Lord, makes me happy. And I know the Lord has really saved my soul. I remember when I came down to that altar, where he took away my sins, made me whole. Yes, he took away my sin, and he made me whole, ever been whole. We got time? Okay. Everybody sing, listen. Yes. I wonder, so aimless, a life filled with sin, I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like an angel in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Everybody now. I saw the light. I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like a blind man, I wandered alone, where ease and cares I claim for my own. And like a blind man, as God gave back his sight, praise the Lord, I saw the light. Till I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more. Sorrows inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light to knock Brother Paul down on the way to Damascus. Amen. Glory to God. Thanks for having us. Go ahead.
I told him we'll give him five songs tonight, and he just, I don't know what's wrong with him. You got problems, son? He's my cousin. I can kid him like that. All right, we'll gather the group back around and do you a song about Mama and the old Licking River. Was some other way. Perhaps down through the years, as time has come and gone, my mother's sweet song will make me glad.
Tonight my mind goes back to that old Lincoln River, to my old Kentucky home upon the hill. I can see that coal lamp burning dimly on the nightstand, and mother's sweet songs are with me still.
Shannon over there will do that song for you, and I know you remember those days, Bill. Probably up there in Indiana where we used to come up and sing, but we'll do that song for you. Want to do it for my sons, number one, Dustin Carter, down in South Carolina working, and his wife, Rachel, listening in tonight, and all the kids, Ethan, son number three, and Amanda, and they've got a little new one. What's his name? I can't
Alexander.
Think of his name. What?
Alexander. Bruce.
Bruce, old Bruce, we call him. And Bruce, this is for you. I know someday they'll show the picture to you. And Carter, let's get my other son there, David, who kind of reneged on us tonight, but he was in court. Carter, will you do High on the Mountain for the folks?
Sure.
And then we'll let your buddy come up and
okay,
sing another
sure.
song.
Also glad to have my daughter Delana here with us tonight.
Yeah. Is that her?
That's her? Oh, that's her.
I'm sorry, Carter. I thought she was awfully friendly to you.
That's my baby girl. And we also do this for Landon, my little son at home. High on the mountain, on a table made of stone, God gave ten commandments, so his children should never go wrong. So his children should never go wrong. Down from the mountain, Moses walked that day. He said he saw an idol, golden calf they were worshiping that day. Golden calf they were worshiping that day. High on a mountain, on a tablet made of stone, God gave his ten commandments, so his children should never go wrong. So his children should never go wrong. Thank you.
with the multitude that day. He brought up the tablets, then he threw them down to the clay. Yes, he threw them down to the clay. High on a mountain, on a tablet made of stone, God gave his Ten Commandments, so his children should never go wrong. So his children should never go wrong.
Carter Bricky, the bluegrass boy of the group, singing about the old Moses there, good man of God, on Mount Sinai, the Ten Commandments. We started out train 45 heading south, and we kind of slowed down a little bit, Carter. He likes to keep it rolling on. Carter, get your buddy up here, sing another song, and then we'll try to close it out. If Delmer won't sing another one, he ought to sing another. Come right up here, brother.
I want to dedicate this song here to my family and all the people out there who is trying to work a ministry and trying to do for the Lord, and all the pastors and all the evangelists out there.
Well, I say unto my Savior, my talent is but small. Although I am a soldier, I am the least of all. One day, as I was thinking of unseen things above, my Savior spoke unto me, and he filled my heart with love. But I'm gonna die on talk with me, but since I've been converted, they turn their backs on me. But I'm gonna die on the battlefield. I'm gonna die in silver, and some they say give me gold, but I say give me Jesus, for he saved this old dying soul. die on the battlefield fighting for my Lord. I'll take this gospel trumpet and I'll begin. Will help me, I will blow wherever I go. Oh, I'm gonna die on the battlefield. I'm gonna die in the hole, and I'm gonna die.
Song, brother, and we're so glad that you're singing for the Lord and preaching for the Lord. Carter, thanks for bringing him along. I don't know how much time we got, but I'm going to have Lady Mary come up here and sing you about an angel that watches over her and all of us, and then we want Dale, if we got time, to come up and sing us a song.
At the beauty shop now. This goes out to you. Seemed I feel the brush of an angel wing hovering over me. Seemed I hear the sound of an angel sing. Guardian angel watching over me. Watching every move I make, watching every step I take, protecting me from harm's way. Right here, Lord, send an angel to watch over me. Praise God for the angel I can see. To Lori Melton. She used to come here and sing a lot with the group. You remember her, Lori Melton? She wrote that. Gary Riley. And I guess I'll send this out to all my kids. I got four kids out there that hope they don't mind me singing like this. And I got 14 grandchildren and 12 great-grandchildren. And when the man was talking about the little boy that was talking, he said he was saying hello to the little girls out there. My little 4-year-old great-granddaughter would have said, I will marry you. Because you talked about getting married the other day for her 4 years old. So I send it out to them. And by the way, his son pastors a church right above me, Elville. No, he's a song leader at the Elville Baptist Church right above me.
Thank you, Mary. Dale, come up. Every time we sing up in Ohio, this will be our closing number. This man comes out, him and his family. You better dedicate your wife a song. I know she's listening tonight. And every time we sing in that general area, He comes out and supports us really good. And we thank him for driving down Sister Margaret to come over here and be with us on this fine, fine program. Dale Hall.
Again, I'm free from sin. I'm happy night and day. Well, it makes me shout, 'cause there's no doubt I know I've been born again. Many times along the way, my faith had grown weak, and trouble seemed to rise on every hand. I kneel down and pray, and I call on his name. He hears and he understands. Well, I'm born again, I'm free from sin. I'm happy night and day. Well, it makes me shout, 'cause there's no doubt. Satan tried to tell me, only thought I got saved. He tells me what a fool I have been. Then my mind goes back to that altar where I prayed, and I know I've been born again. One more time. Well, I'm born again, free from sin. I'm happy night. It makes me shout, 'cause there's no doubt I know I've been born again. Yes, I know that I've been born again. Of the water and the spirit. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory.
I will quick read this to Margaret. I wrote it for Margaret, so I'm going to write what I wrote for you. I almost didn't, but can I read this to you, Margaret? Okay. It says, in a little town called Beattyville, on a mountain tall and strong, stands a tower of signal called WLJC-TV, where there is something good going on. There sits a lovely lady named Margaret, who loves to read scriptures and say a lot of prayers, and she sends forth the word to all the people to call. Listen to our songs, listen to our music, and just rest for a while. If unsaved, call and we will pray, and Jesus will save your soul. And the ones who are saved will be lifted up and encouraged to keep holding on. And we will pray for the sick to be healed when you call this number, 606-464-3600, WLJC, Setting on a Hill.
Hear, hear.
All right. Thank you, Mary. Appreciate that. Talking about being saved, we have some more good news to rejoice in here tonight from Corbin. Brenda has called and said the sinner's prayer, and she's saved tonight. And also from Stanford, Kentucky, Jason has called and wanted and gave his heart to the Lord and wanted to hear the song "Go Rest High on the Mountain." And anyway, that is two more souls tonight, and how we thank the Lord for it. Well, we appreciate all the songs you have listened to tonight, and Preacher Bill about the Youth Haven Camp, and we've all done what we could, and in our ability to share the good news with you. And so appreciate Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio from West Liberty. They do have CDs. Now, I remember we used to have the big old 33 and third records that we played on the in the beginning of radio by the Carter family. And now, you know, of course, they got them down to CDs, DVDs, and so forth. But if you'd like to get in touch with them to purchase their merchandise and keep their singing in your home, call 606-743-2847, and they'll be glad to hear from you. Well, we have a number of prayer requests in, and we're just going to pray over all of them and pray for these two that has just accepted the Lord in the last few minutes, and also this great outreach again that we have for WLJC, and we'll talk more about that later. But right now, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy, and we thank you for the salvation of these tonight. And we know that you tell us to go and to preach and the word and to get the gospel out in song, in spoken word, or in printed material, or whatever, Lord, you want the gospel out. And we thank you for each person that is working for you. And we pray for a protective covering over each one that's heart is in the right place. And Lord, this new endeavor that WLJC is going in, we ask you for your angels to clear the way. Let it continue to go to more and more places. And bless each person that has joined us in this avenue. We thank you tonight, Father, for your love and your goodness to us, and we pray for all of these requests that has come in. Some are really serious. Some are praising you for what you have done for them, and so, Lord, help us to never forget to praise you for your goodness to us. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, we do appreciate this group for coming, and so we'll be talking more about this new avenue that we're in now, reaching more souls. And so if you want more information on it, call Rachel. She works in the office here, and at 859-229-6679. And if you're a little confused about what we're talking about, well, she can explain it really well, a lot better than I can. So she'd be glad to hear from you. Well, we have run out of time. So from all of us here in the studio, we want to say good night and God bless you.
WLJC programs, including the live WLJC chapel service, are brought to you through your contributions of support to Hour of Harvest Incorporated. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deductions. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed of what's happening at WLJC, along with our monthly guest list, give us a call at 606-464-3600 or write to us, WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Or if you would like to join our email list, log on to www.wljc.com and sign up today. It's so easy and it's free.
Their sufferings untold, each one longing for Jesus, despairing heart, silent cry, empty of pride and self now, on him to rely.
Bring in the harvest, tell of his mercy and grace, tell how he loves them. The whole human race, bring in the harvest, send out the light. Souls are waiting.
WLJC programs, including the live WLJC chapel service, are brought to you through your contributions of support to Hour of Harvest Incorporated. All contributions made to WLJC.